Hey everyone, Scott here, and we're going to do another driving video today. As I was filming the I-71 South video, I realized, the quality may not be the greatest because of the sun being in the way, so I figure I'd go ahead and do a second driving video today to make up for it a little bit. But yeah, we're going to go north on 23 north from I-270, the north part of the loop up to Delaware, Ohio. But yeah, this is actually a new construction here, as they now have these express lanes which can bypass a lot of these different traffic lights through here. And when I was coming down to Columbus back in November 2015, this was all under construction. So this is really cool to see the finished product. I got to pass up all those different traffic lights back there, but I still have these up ahead. But it's a beautiful day out today. It's in the low 40s right now, so it's not super warm, but at the same time it's not terribly cold, so it's actually pretty nice out today. Nice and sunny down here compared to what it is like up in Michigan right now, or up in Michigan, it's really cloudy. In fact, I can see a bunch of clouds way off to the north of here. So it was a great day to come down to the Columbus area. But as you can tell, a lot of traffic lights in this area. Surely. But yeah, when driving between Columbus and Toledo, this is the slowest stretch either way, because you have all the different traffic lights in this area, especially back that way. But once you get north out of the Columbus area, things get a little bit better. But yeah, once you get north of Delaware and Delaware State Park, then it starts to get even better as it becomes more of an expressway. But yeah, as you can tell over in here, a lot of development. I didn't go into downtown Columbus today, well, other than I-71, but I wanted to drive around around the Columbus area just for a little bit, because it is a nice day out, and want to take advantage of the nice weather, especially because it's cold and gray in Michigan, although I already said that already today. Traffic up ahead. It's probably a good thing I'm not here 2 to 3 hours later than now. It's almost 2 o'clock p.m. right now. If I were coming through here like at 4:30 or 5 o'clock, this would be horrible at rush hour. Shopping stores in here, Marshall's, Michael's, Home Goods, or even your different restaurants like Tim Hortons and Bob Evans, and then Meijer off to the left. And we're gonna have to stop again here. shopping here is, as you can tell, Kohl's and Walmart over here. Home Depot, and then Buffalo Wild Wings, Ruby Tuesday. We got a Smashburger and Chipotle. I think I've only been to Smashburger twice. Well, not down in Columbus, but up in the Detroit area. I've been to a couple of them, and they're pretty good. I can use a total pun right now, but to describe about Smashburger, but you may not want to hear it because it's probably a bad pun. If you know what I mean. But yeah, I feel like I've stopped at every traffic light in this past mile. Stop for once. But yeah, now we're starting to get more out of the Columbus area. Now that the speed limit is going up, but of course I get another traffic light up ahead though. Oh, what do you know? I actually just turned green. Since I was just about to pause the recording, but don't have to now. But yeah, as I was saying earlier, yeah, you can see all of the clouds up off to the north of here. Because yeah, as I was coming down here today, it was pretty cloudy until I got down toward like Delaware. Then it got really sunny. It's like, yeah, another traffic light coming up ahead, but looks like it's been red for a little while. Yep, because, yeah, won't really have to really stop here this time, so that's good because we need to get rolling here. Because I'm actually going to be filming two more videos today. I will be going up to Delaware State Park, north of Delaware. Actually, past that, I'm on my way down this morning, but it was kind of cold then. It'd be a lot warmer now. Actually, a lot nicer out. And then actually, we'll be doing a Travel Delights video back up in the Ann Arbor, Ypsilanti, Michigan area. Although it'll probably be dark by the time I get there. Wow, this is the second time in this video where I was just about to pause and it turns green. I think the traffic lights here in Columbus are playing mind games with me right now. Well, that's a fancy car wash off to the right. But yeah, I'm going to film this all the way till I get through around Delaware, Ohio. Probably stop the video around the north side of the city area. I think I can probably get over a lane. nice day, I have to say. It does not feel like late December. Feels more like late November, to be honest. But yeah, this is the third video overall, or the second driving video that I've been filming with this new GoPro I bought last month. And it's pretty nice, I have to say. It's a lot easier to set up for these driving videos than the old setup with my other camera. For my Let's Visit videos, at least for a while, I'm going to continue using the camera I have been using for the past 2.5-3 years. Because it does a great job, and you can zoom in with that, unlike the GoPro. But the GoPro is great for these driving videos because it's easy to set up. Travel with the lights videos, and then also any like vlogs that I may do. Video with this, I think it was the weekend before Christmas, and I was really impressed with the quality of the video. It's like if I really wanted to, I could film this with 4K, but I'll really eat away at my battery if I do that. I did buy a second battery this GoPro, but I didn't bring it with me today because I knew for a fact I would not come close to running out of battery today. Although this was a weekend trip, I would have made a rookie mistake. Although technically I could easily charge this up in a hotel room. With how easy this setup is for the driving videos with this GoPro, I'm probably be doing a lot more driving videos now, because this is so easy to set up compared to the other setup. Heck, it wouldn't surprise me if people were giving me funny looks when they saw that camera and book setup that I had previously. It got the job done, though, when I was doing the driving videos last year and then 2015, but I could have really used this GoPro when I did that trip to the United Kingdom back in 2015. I could actually have filmed on the left side of the road over there, because I did not want to take that big book and the scotch tape with me for that one. And plus, even with that setup, not a lot of cars have the capabilities of having that book to be able to be taped on the dashboard. Oh, just go over the Olentangy River here. But how nice this mount is, I can actually take this on any trip. Like, I could get a rental car on a weekend trip, vacation, or even a business trip. Assuming I have a rental car. And I'm going to go ahead and pause it here. Sorry about that, but at least we made a lot more progress than back in that shopping area. Coming into Delaware, or I should say coming back to Delaware, because I actually filmed a video here this morning. Got lucky with that traffic light, that the car behind me actually went through it, but driving through a smaller shopping area. This is more for the southern part of Delaware compared to the northern part of the Columbus metro area. Unfortunately, though, I'm not going to get so lucky with this light. Can't blame the lorries, though. They take a little while to get going, though, especially after a complete stop. Turn left there, that would take you into downtown Delaware. Oh, but yeah, I'm about to stop at this light, however. Bypassing the main stretch of downtown to the east. But yeah, walking around downtown Delaware was pretty nice. I really enjoyed the downtown area. A lot of people out and about at the different stores, and then when it got close to lunchtime, eating at some of the great restaurants. Small stretch of road work here. And then, yeah, during my Let's Visit video, actually, although I didn't get it on camera, but I actually was walking across that pedestrian bridge, which, going to the left, that takes you over to Ohio Wesleyan University. But yeah, I'm probably not going to be filming for too much more. But I definitely wanted to do another driving video today, going north where there'd be a lot less sun, basically to make up for that last video. But yeah, I do apologize for all the glare from the sun in that I-71 south video. Probably should have done a northbound video instead, but there's always a future, though. So, yeah, after I get out of Delaware, I'm going to head up to the state park, do a video, and then head back to cloudy Michigan. But it is nice, though, that they have this little bypass of downtown Delaware, so that way you don't have to stop at all the different traffic lights in downtown if you went on Sandusky Street. So, yep, here's where Sandusky Street comes out of. So, if you enjoyed this video, definitely give this video a like or a thumbs up. For more Scottman895 trail videos, definitely click that subscribe button. I upload videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. At the end of every video, links to my Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram pages. Well, thank you for watching today's driving video here on Highway 23, going from I-270 north part of the loop up to the north parts of Delaware, Ohio. And this is Scott setting out.